because it's a horse-on country, but it is also, we have seen last time, this is fourth-on country. That is why it is coming to Kerala. And we have got such love and affection towards Kerala. And sir, I would request you that after the initiative taken by Dr. Kishore and his members of the faculty to start a seminar like this, it is imperative that we move forward. So the best thing that you can do, sir, is to allow LNCP to start a diploma course in sports law. Now, from next year onwards, we must have new courses like sports management, biomechanics. We must have courses on diploma courses in for even lifeguard, for swimming. We should have courses for masters, and you know, a thorough revamp of the academic curriculum in LNCP, in NIS Patiala, and in other academic institutions is required. And I'm sure the Honorable Minister will look into this and take the necessary steps. And the sports law, as I said earlier, yesterday, is such an important area where we are very, very backward. We don't know that there is something, some sports law exists. People have often pointed out cases of Sarita Devi, cases of Judy Chant, cases of Shanti Sautarajan. All could have been avoided had we had the enough expertise, enough knowledge on these areas. So it is very important that we develop sufficient expertise in sports law and arbitration. So it is imperative that Sports Authority of India take the initiative to start new courses for this, and that would be the best outcome of this initiative. I'm sure the Honorable Minister will think on these lines, and I congratulate the doctor, the principal, the members of the faculty, and all of them who participated, especially the faculty who have come from abroad for giving such input. And I'm told that yesterday you had a Skype conference, and you would have seen how people sitting far away can talk to you. And this is how we should develop. You see, when we have a course, we start a new course on sports law, we can definitely bring in this faculty from different parts of the world to lecture, and that will enable us to move forward. Congratulations once again, and thank you very much.
The Honorable Minister for Forest, Environment, Transport, Sports and Cinema, Government of Kerala, Shri Tevachu Ramakrishna.
Shri Chief Secretary, Shri Gigi Thompson, Shri Kira Padhan, Arthur Nimai, Bhatna Shri Priti Usha, Shri Nilsson, Josiah Konantan, Shri Abhiresh Kumar, Shri G. Kishore, dear friends and comrades. I am giving my prepared speech. While seeing your enthusiasm, I think that it is my duty to say thanks to you all on behalf of Kerala. Because you are looking the maximum to get a good number of world medals in Kerala side. So for that, I am thankful to you on behalf of Kerala. I am not taking much of your time because the voluntary function is fast approaching. So I must also be there as the host of this function. So I am not taking much of your time. The excellent work rendered by LNCP, I am appreciating and welcoming the work. I think that wonderful things can be happened if we go in the right direction which you are following now. Thank you very much.
Shri Sarvananda Sonowal, Honorable Minister of State, holding independent charge for youth affairs and sports.
Honorable Minister for Sports and Youth Affairs, Government of Kerala, Sri Rakhakrishnanji, the Chief Secretary of the Government of Kerala, Sri Gigi Thompsonji, Padma Shri, Srimati P.T. Usaji, Padma Shri, Sri Nilsson Ji, and Professor Lucio Colantwani, Professor Dr. Kishu Hira Vallabhji, and Nirmal Singhji, and Dr. Amaritji, and other dignitaries, and ladies and gentlemen. First of all, I'd like to thank the government of Kerala for organizing their 35th National Games nicely. And whatever report I have received from the different contingents, it was very nice to hear from them. They have been very comfortable during their stay in Kerala. And at the same time, they deserve congratulations because I think they stood first among all other states in terms of getting permission for the medal. And also, I especially congratulate Dr. Kishu, MMCP, because a sizable number of medals have also been achieved by our product. It's good. As a small routine speech here, if you permit, can I read it out? I am delighted to be amidst you this afternoon on the occasion of the valedictory ceremony of First National Workshop on Sports Law we were held in our country. Coinciding with the 35th National Games. Let me at the very outset express my sincere appreciation to Shri Pralad Singh Patel, Honorable Member of Parliament, for his initiative, and Sai Lakshmibai Dasgupta College of Physical Education for facilitating this workshop. The topic, effectiveness of sports arbitration for promotion of sports in India, is very crucial and deserves top priority at the present. This is relevant because various sports bodies consisting of athletes, administrators, officials, IOA, and officers of center and state governments often have to confront many legal issues and disputes related to sports causing disturbance to the sports activities in India. Nowadays, sports have become both highly competitive and commercialized across the world, and India is not exception to it. Moreover, with the increasing commercialization of sports in the format of the 19th Commonwealth Games 2010 Delhi, the need to regulate sports has also become a necessity in tune with the sports regulatory framework prevailing in different countries. Interventions of the Indian sports and Indian sports regulatory mechanism and then banned by the International Olympic Committee on the Indian Olympic Movements made it even more necessary that universal modernization structures, systems and processes for the resolutions of sports-related disputes be followed, which should be more sports-centric, transparent and accountable in their functions, which call less sportiva, less unitaria. Therefore, a robust dispute resolution mechanism, especially a strong grievance redressal mechanism for athletes, needs to be put in place. It is neither feasible nor desirable that government takes upon itself the burden of interventions when disputes arise within national sports bodies. It is affiliated units and Indian Olympic Association. Looking at the recent incidents affecting adversely some of the Indian athletes, there is a need to facilitate such athletes by the government as well as sports bodies. National sports organizations to reform and modernize themselves so that the athletes do not get entangled into avoidable controversy and litigation. Let me also point out here that the initiative taken by Sports Authority of India to ensure justice to Kumari Dutisha, who got unfairly maligned due to gender discrimination. I have given an assurance to the parliament that the athlete will be given full assistance to defend her case. Accordingly, I engaged one of the top lawyers from Canada, who is familiar with such cases, to fight on behalf of duty. So I could succeed in securing an order that allowed duty to participate in this national games. The stand of the government has been indicated as duty stand has won gold in 100 meter race with a meet record of 11.7. I hope to get a favorable verdict from CAT soon so that Dutishan can compete in international events also. With the growth of sports, many cases like Duti may arise in future, and it is our burden duty to protect the athletes so that their morale remains high. Thankful to Shri Prahlad Singh Patel, Member of Parliament, for organizing this important conference come to Oxford during the National Games on behalf of the governmental bodies, which should be a regular feature for all future National Games. I believe the deliberation of this workshop will have a lasting effect on the promotion of sports in India. I also appreciate the willingness of the Sports Law India for coming forward and extending support of professional sports lawyers to defend the cases of the athletes and sports bodies for quick disposal so that the peak performance of the athlete do not go in vain. Simultaneously, I would also like to caution all the stakeholders that they should refrain from indulging in undue litigation and should use the arbitration mechanism solely for the benevolence of the athletes. On behalf of the Government of India, I assure to extend all necessary help and support to take forward this post arbitration mechanism effectively so that the spirit of Olympic movement is preserved. And here, as G.G. Thompson has proposed a program be introduced in this particular famous institution to start a diploma course of sports law. This is a very important suggestion, and we have extended this matter will be definitely looked into. We have so many laws. We have sales law, cyber law, criminal law, civil law, so many laws. But sports law is absolutely essential. How to What is the right of an athlete, of a coach, of an organizer, and the federation? It should all be well determined. So that whoever is involved in the world of sports, he or she must have the crystal clear knowledge of the event, the right. Because without knowing the right, the parameter cannot be determined. What should be the legal behavior when you play sports? That legal behavior has to be asserted. I think it requires a lot of resource work, a lot of nice interaction. Today we are very happy that like legal man from abroad has come and contributed distribution power of our system. And I being a sports minister, I firmly believe that this particular subject has to be taken on the top of the priority agenda. And across the country, particularly in the legal sense, the legal evidence about sports has to be, you know, upgraded in the mindset of our people. And like even in the villages also, wherever we are developing infrastructure, to identify the future generation of our country. Those like our young people, like our players should be taught about their sports law, their rights, and their duties and obligations. How to maintain the sanctity of the event and the discipline, and how to make sports in the way of life. I believe that is the priority for me. If I can make this particular country acceptable to this extent of accepting sports as a way of life, then definitely this will be a subject of everybody's consideration. So with these few words, I again extend my heartiest thanks to the government of Canada, and because I was also there on the day of inauguration,